ancient Taoist and Chinese philosophy and modern science will now be combined to give a timeless view of the various concepts of the life force or vital energies of the body, as well as outside of the body. A Taoist canon states, the process of realization involves being fully conscious of the intrinsic identity of all universal energy, the reservoir of heaven. Pour into it, and it is never full. Dip from it, and it never runs dry. And yet, it does not know where the supply comes from. This is called the precious light. Energy can neither be created nor destroyed, is modern physics analogy of the above quotation by Chang Su. The translation of the Chinese term qi is absolute. Modern science refers to the qi energy as a subtle electromagnetic force. Every process of the human body is, in fact, electrochemical. Within the cell, within the molecular level, the electrolytes being the positive and negative ions or charged protons and electrons, when in a flowing polarity, supply the bioelectrical current. Bioenergy flow is disrupted when too many protons condense, impeding the supply of electrons. The cumulative flow of electrons and protons at the atomic, thus molecular, and resultingly the cellular level, creates the subtle electromagnetic force or momentum animating the body and its activities. Our entire body is like a giant electric machine. Body chemistry, like all chemistry, is based on electrical bonds. The body even runs on electricity. The energy you need to hear these words came from the egg you ate for breakfast. The egg got its energy from the corn consumed by the hen. The corn extracted the energy directly from the electromagnetic light of the sun through photosynthesis. The new physics states the electromagnetic fluidum, which should surround all the cells of the body, is the vehicle that binds the energy to the cellular level. Besides enhancing nutrient absorption and tissue elasticity, these fluids also insulate the organism from bacterial and viral attack. The qi energy is not only the composition and nourishment of the body, but its protection as well.